And on the start line in Colac, 55 riders on the start line, 18 of the riders eligible for the best young rider classification, which is for those born after the 1st of January 2004. Perfect starting location for them, David McKenzie, at the Colac Velodrome before getting out onto the open roads.
Yeah, it is a great start. And, you know, Colac's got a rich history of, you know, obviously the Warrnambool going through there for many, many years. There used to be the Melbourne to Colac race. So, no, great that they utilised the Velodrome as well. But it didn't take long, Matty, for the first attack to come. And obviously Team Bridgelane, one of the teams with numbers and a strong team here, eager to sort of kick things off and utilise their numbers.
It was then on to the first of the KFC Queen of the Mountains prizes that was up for grabs. There's three of the climbs throughout today's race. And on the first of the climbs, which came after just 8 kilometres having been covered.
Pack or down the back, because there's a bunch of new names that she probably doesn't even know here that she's got to keep an eye on.
Exactly. She's ridden the Australian National Championships recently. Obviously, she's won the time trial so many times, four-time winner of that. But there are a lot of faces that she's not particularly familiar with. This was Josephine Pepper timing her run to perfection to get to the top of the first of the climbs in the race for the Queen of the Mountains classification. We saw early yesterday it was Jack Aiken who had a similar strategy of picking up all the early climbs to take out King of the Mountains and the sprint prize yesterday.
Yeah, it was great riding by Aiken, and he was part of that big long breakaway that, as you say, he sort of gobbled up all of the KOM and sprint classification points. But again, you could just see Bridgelane here really on the march, and Caitlin Nicholson here. A clear tactic, Matt. They're obviously from Pat Shaw to, you know, utilise the numbers early and try and put numbers up the road in the breakaway. But it was the other team, ARA Skip Capital, who weren't going to give any leeway, any room at all. Find another way to win today, I think.
And a breakaway group starting to form off the front. Through to the finish on Raglan Parade, exactly as we saw yesterday. This is the Cycling Development Foundation. This is Sophia Sammons coming through towards the front, one of the West Australians in the race.
And that looks like Josephine Pepper, who took that first QOM. So she's on the hunt for Butterfields here.
Amanda Poulsen is the rider who's in the move for Team Bridgelane. And she hasn't been racing for very long. She's been racing for around about 12 months. She was born in Denmark. She spent a lot of her childhood in various Asian countries where she grew up, including Singapore, a little bit in Malaysia as well, I believe. She was part of the Danish football team, playing soccer, had a knee injury, took up cycling, and finds herself at the top end of the Australian peloton pretty quickly. And we saw the salt stains on all the riders at the back end of the race yesterday. And despite the mist and the fog that we saw at the start today in Colac, those clouds have clearly burnt off, clear blue skies, and it is warming up significantly.
That is the key point, isn't it? Who is going to chase and which team has some strength here? So, no, I like this. This makes the race very interesting, and, you know, I guess we can argue none of the favourites are in that breakaway. So, at some point, there'll be just a few nervous riders, I would think.
Life.
Could be a big day. Well, there's the board. I was just wondering what the gap is, 3:20.
At 58 seconds to Munt, who is stuck in the middle, if she wants the points, she'll be tough to beat.
Yeah, she'll be very hard to beat. And she's got the bike IQ as well to go with it. So, no, they will sprint this out. They're all looking over their shoulder.
And here goes Pepper. She opens up the sprint. It's Poulsen who is at the front, or was at the front, going toe-to-toe with her. Pepper now gets the lead. No challenge coming from Stewart, nor Sammons. Pepper is almost there. She gets across the top. Three more points in the race for the KFC Queen of the Mountains classification. Mathematically, she has got that locked up. She needs to get to the finish line.
Grace Brown, you can just see she's now just trying to sort of stem the flow here, if you like, of this break. She doesn't want it to get out to 5-6 minutes. If she's going to attack somewhere, she wants it. You know, we know she's got the capability of crossing a 2-minute gap potentially, Grace Brown, because of her expertise against the clock, and obviously she's world class. But she doesn't want this to go out to 5 minutes.
Now we have Marion Munt. She's out to 2 minutes. It was 58 seconds the last check we saw, and this group are close to 4 minutes ahead of the peloton. You can see the flag off the left-hand side of the road. Pepper squeezes the throttle to make sure of it. No challenge coming from Poulsen. So it will be Josie Pepper going out the winner of the KFC Queen of the Mountains classification. The polka dots await in Warrnambool and a little fist pump to go with it. And this is the famous bridge heading towards the 12 Apostles. It is a postcard on the back of a bike race.
It is. It's absolutely stunning. And I actually drove this coastline on a holiday just prior to Christmas. It is just absolutely magnificent. And you think, gee, it's on our doorstep. You and I both live in Melbourne. You know, it's not that far away. And my wife and I were driving it just in amazement. It's been quite a few years since I've been down this far. And on a day like today, I mean, wow, it's really just showing off, isn't it?
Well, in her first National Road Series race, doing a fantastic job. Her teammate, Amy Humphreys, is in this group. So too is another one of her teammates, Sophie Chapman. So they're struggling at the back as the peloton is splitting up.
It is.
Pat Shaw is on the phone. Pat, what's the strategy from Team Bridge Lane?
Well, I can't tell you what the strategy is, mate, but it's a complex race. The Warnie always is. But we got out of the car, felt a bit of wind, and we wanted to animate the people watching, so I hope they're loving it.
We are loving it. You've got Amanda Poulsen in the breakaway, but you've got plenty of your riders, along with Grace Brown, at the front of the peloton, causing some problems for lots of others.
Yeah, well, it's one of these ones that a lot of the other teams, unfortunately, are racing very negatively, and we want to put on a good show. We want to prove that our riders are ready for Europe, and that's why we're riding in this way. We expect this caliber of performance from our athletes.
Who's your number one from your team? Who's the most likely to win from Bridge Lane today?
Oh, I think Amanda Poulsen will win from the breakaway.
Okay, we're now seeing riding off the front, Hayley Fuller from your team is breaking away from the peloton.
Yeah, look, I'm really proud of our group and how they've grown over the last 12 months, guys. And I don't have to say as much on the radio anymore, which they like as well.
And Pat, this, let's just go back to exactly where the race is at the moment. The last gap we heard was about 3 minutes and 20 seconds. Can the brake survive to the finish?
Well, we can turn the switch off back here whenever we want. So, yes, it can.
Will it?
No, I'm not 100% sure because our tactics might change. We're trying to work with Grace Brown here. Like, she's motivated to split the race. We're motivated to do the same. But if we don't work, no one's going to work. So we'll just go back in for 4 minutes anyway. So I'm not really all that worried either way, to be honest.
Team Bridge Lane once again coming to the front and opening up the throttle. Is predominantly a tailwind at this point, but as we can see by the lack of the movement with the grass and the trees on the side, it's hardly noticeable.
Yeah, I don't think, and maybe I'll speak too soon here, but I'm not sure this is going to do too much damage here based on what you've just said, Matt, because yesterday for the men, this same spot, there was enough wind, but it was proven, it split. I just don't think it's going to happen here.
The throttle has really opened up. That was Purdy Long at the back in the pink colours of the Total Rush women's team. It's a fantastic mountain bike, but she's caught out of position here because it is moving at the head of affairs.
Oh, yeah, and I just saw Summer Nordmeyer there, the 18-year-old, just showing a little bit of lack of experience. Bit on up, going back to the cars. This is when you don't go back to get food or drinks. This is when you sit tight. No matter how much or desperate you are, wait 5 more minutes or wait a few minutes at least to see if the pace drops off. This could be a dangerous point when you want to go back for drinks down the right side of the road, but there's barely a breath of wind. So they're sitting on the wheel. And if you would
fall on the right-hand side or to just manage to keep it up. That was Keely Bennett who's gone off-road. Keely Bennett, the Australian under 23 criterium champion, she saves it. That was...
But what it's done, it's caused a reaction and it's caused a bit of a split here. So you can just see now, a few women are just finding the going a bit tough. Couple of gaps opening up, Matt.
Some serious gaps are opening up. Summer Nordmeyer, who you just spoke about, she's been caught behind the split. She went back to the team car to collect some water bottles and the peloton is under some serious pressure. And it's Bridge Lane who is doing the damage.
Well, they've persevered, haven't they? You wouldn't have blamed them if they'd sort of eased up there and said, well, it's not working. They didn't. They stuck to their guns.
Oh, there's a split. One of their riders is missing the split. That's Caitlin Nicholson. She's number 15, trying to close down the wheel of Lily Pollock. Sophie Edwards is still in this group in the white colours. Alice Simpson, the under 23 Australian time trial champion, is also there for ARA Skip Capital. And one rider has made the front group from the Total Rush team. That is impressive.
split it again, but they're still at it here. So that change in direction was just momentarily. And again, Grace Brown is sort of... There's three riders that have just nipped off the front here.
They have indeed. Number 46, that's Shani Morley, who was ninth last year. We just spoke to her sports director, Shannon Malseed. Shannon will be happy to see that Shani is still in with the big favourites. Neath the wheel, with the wind coming from the right-hand side, just dodging the bullet was Emma Pratt. And there's been a huge fall in the group. Steph Hibbert has gone down. She's the rider from the... Rock Salt team, two riders down, one from ARA from Bridge Lane as well. A couple from Bridge Lane have gone down. The defending champion in the white colours, Sophie Edwards, is also off to the side of the road. This is chaos. Here's another look at it. And they were going really quick at this point. This is close to 50 k's per hour, based on what we saw before with the breakaway group. Yeah. The peloton was certainly going quicker than them.
100%.
It is down to 3 minutes, the gap now to the peloton. This is cramp for Sammons. This is Sophia Sammons, or is it a mechanical problem? She has come to a grinding halt.
It's like a little bit of indecision in that chase group now as well.
So this is a replay for Sophia Sammons. That's cramp.
It's cramp, yeah. Ooh.
That's disappointing for Sophia Sammons. But this is, she's one of the youngest riders in the race. And somehow, Sophia Sammons, after the cramp, has got herself reorganised. And she has caught the leaders once again.
Wow.
Phoenix Rising. This is impressive.
Yeah.
This is the chase. This is Lauren Thomas, riding for the Lockhart Energy Composite team. And she's stuck in the middle, but she's still chasing in hope that she can close it down. And it's a slight downhill stretch here, but she's hooking along.
Yeah.
2 minutes and to one rider chasing. 2:40 back to the peloton. That one rider chasing is Lauren Thomas.
26 riders by the looks of it too, which is what's left of the peloton.
Here comes the peloton being led by Grace Brown as they are still on the streets of Allensford. Last year's winner in the white jersey is Sophie Edwards. And they've lost all impetus, the peloton.
That is done, yeah. Yep, they are fighting for the minor places here. Well, she's got support from family and friends, as she said, she comes from Camperdown.
It's Sophie Sammons at the back, and now it is Josie Pepper from Butterfields who is the first to attack, and Amanda Poulsen, number 14 from Team Bridge Lane. Lucy Stewart, no problems responding to that move by Pepper.
No
problems. This opens up the window, though, for Poulsen to launch the counterattack.
Yeah, and Poulsen is just laying off a length or two there. There was no issues for Poulsen to get on the wheel. Sammons probably not quite the same. She's just got to nurse it in here.
And she's gotten back onto the wheel. And Lucy Stewart, the rider renowned as the best sprinter from this group, is the next to attack.
And Poulsen is playing a bluff. Well, she's rolling the dice here. She's trying to rely on Pepper going on the move. She is looking for that last kicker, I think, to attack. Or has she just not got the legs?
It may well be the latter, because she's struggling to stick in the slipstream here of Pepper. Sophia Sammons is most definitely out of contention. Lucy Stewart, she's hugging the right-hand side of the road because the wind is coming from the left. She takes a look across the shoulder. She can give herself a little bit more space on the road now because there's nobody in her slipstream. She's got free road, free air to play with.
Well, this is it. What now? The question is being asked to Amanda Poulsen and, of course, Josephine Pepper. Pepper couldn't go with that initial surge, but it's a long 5 kilometres at the end of 155. But Lucy Stewart, look at this. She is riding like she's fresh, Matt. Look at the turn of speed she's got here. She hits the outskirts now, right on the outskirts of Warrnambool. This will start to give her some good vibes, some good feels. And what about the two chasers? Well, it's not done because Poulsen now is rotating. So they've actually closed this up a little bit.
and they have to work together. At the back end of the year at the Tour of Bright, they had a short individual time trial there of 15.8 kilometres. She was fourth in that time trial, so she's good against the clock. She'll have some confidence from those results.
And just those couple of moments, that last shot then, what you could see, Stewart absolutely accelerated before that descent, so she could tuck in and freewheel. She got as aerodynamic as possible. Pepper behind, she got to the front of her turn, but didn't try and accelerate fast. She tucked in straight away. You've got to get that speed up, and then your weight and obviously the gravity there will drag you down. So Stewart was just smarter with how she hit that downhill section. It wasn't much. It's only a 500 metre little descent. But at the end of a day like this, it could make all the difference.
It still is a tenuous gap.
But they're close enough. They're close enough. They've still got a sniff at this. And Pepper now attacking Paulson.
And this can close the gap a little momentarily. But if Paulson gets back onto her, we could see them pause again. But Pepper has got the gap. And she's making a little bit of ground up on Lucy Stewart. This is still a long way from being over. It's one chasing one, chasing one.
Yeah, what a ride by Pepper. She's really shown today that she's been one of the strongest of these four. Brilliant ride from her, and the fact that she's prepared to attack Paulson, and Paulson now really struggling. And the more she sits at 5-10 metres behind Pepper, it's going to hurt her. Downhill run there would have helped Pepper. This uphill drag, I think, will shift in the favour of Stewart. Remember, she attacked on an incline. She showed she was the strongest of the four. Now she hits that last incline towards the line.
Fourth generation cyclist, Lucy Stewart. She's got cycling coursing through her veins, and she's about to be a winner of the Warrnambool Women's Cycling Classic. She takes a look across the shoulder. She will have heard stories from the family about Raglan Parade and winning in Warrnambool. One last look for confirmation. Stewart, sensational, goes out the winner of the Warrnambool Women's Classic. Fourth last year, first this time around. Josie Pepper across the line in second. There's Dad waiting. Pepper in second. Paulson rounds out the podium in third.
Wow, great win. Great win by Lucy Stewart. As we had said and you pointed out, she was probably the quickest there, but she wanted to win solo. She wanted to go on the attack, and you can just see she has left it all out there.
Sprint for sixth place, and it's Sophie Edwards trying to get over the top. Keely Bennett, I think it is, that's managed to just get. There's Keely Bennett in for sixth. Sophie Edwards, last year's winner, in for seventh position.
So we're here with the winner from ARA Skip Capital, Lucy Stewart, fourth last year. But today, your face tells it all. Tell us how you're feeling.
Oh, I'm just in absolute disbelief. Like, I didn't have too much confidence going into this race. I've sat out all of January with a broken collarbone. But, the team had confidence in me once I was in that break, and had Hank and Dave in the car saying, "You got this." And yeah, I think we came into this race with such a strong team and so many options, and yeah, it wasn't really the plan for me to be away that early, but I was following moves for the team with such good sprinters in the bunch, and I actually felt quite good out there, and we started working, and in the end I'm sort of more of a sprinter, but yeah, I didn't really want to wait to the end for a sprint, so I just dug the heels in and gave it everything, and yeah, held on, so wrap.
Now, the breakaway was a long day, maybe 100 k's in the breakaway or more.
Like 120, it was ridiculous, and that's why I was a bit tentative at first. Because we had such fast girls in the back, so I just sort of sat on, and once we got a solid gap, I was like, I may as well work, because this could turn into something.
Now, in those final moments when the breakaway, you started looking at each other a bit more. When did you make the decision to go, right, I'm going to go on attack and try and do the solo instead of sprinting?
I knew it would always be a bit of cat and mouse coming into it. But, I think yesterday, Marco, everyone was on the ropes and Marco hit it. So I sort of did the same thing. I could hear them all hurting behind me, and I thought it's all or nothing. So I just, gave it a go and held on. So I can't complain with that.
Well, new Lockhart Energy Women's Warrnambool Champion, how's that sound?
Oh, it sounds amazing, but didn't do it all on my own. Strong girls in the breakaway, and thanks to the team for backing me for the win.
Congratulations. congratulations. Let you celebrate with the team.
Thanks, Jethro.